Oh, hi, gorgeous.
Yes, you. You're gorgeous. Gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous. They're like, she's psycho. Maple and bacon. One salty, one sweet. Both opposites, but opposites attract. Today, we're creating the perfect marriage between two flavors in macaron form. And if this is what true love is made of, well, then consider me the matchmaker. When I first started catering many, many years ago, maple bacon was one of the first flavors on my menu. And today I'm sharing it with you, you. Yes, you, gorgeous. You, you, you. It has that smoky, sweet, salty comfort taste in your mouth. It all in one bite. Well, I guess it depends on how big your mouth is because I have to have two bites. But for most of you, it's one bite. And this recipe will live rent-free in your mind forever. Guys, I'll be posting the recipes and links to the products I use in the caption below, and be sure to use the comment section to ask me any questions you want, except how old I am, and maybe my social security number. But seriously, ask me anything. But before we get started, please subscribe to my channel, ring that bell for notifications on new content, and like this video for even more baking videos. Thank you.
Gracias. Grazie. Merci beaucoup.
To start making our maple bacon French macaroons, we're going to start by making our French meringue in a stand mixer, or you can also use a bowl with a hand mixer. Both produce the same results. And while your meringue is mixing up, we're going to sift our almond flour and our confectioner's sugar together into a bowl. We're going to combine our egg whites, cream of tartar, and salt in your mixer, and then mix it on high until the egg whites are foamy. Once you get to that stage, you can turn your mixer down and slowly add your granulated sugar. And then once that's combined, you can switch your mixer to high and let it go until a hard, stiff meringue has formed. In the meantime, we're going to sift our almond flour and confectioner's sugar together in a larger bowl. And we want to make sure we get all the clumps out of this. I only sift it once. I know some people do it a few times, but I only found once to be necessary because I like to use really finely ground almond flour. And then if you have a little bit residue left in your sifter, that's okay. You can get rid of it, maybe like a tablespoon, but you don't want to throw away more than a tablespoon. Now we're gonna combine our meringue all at once with our dry ingredients, and we're going to fold it a little bit, but not completely. You don't wanna add gel food coloring to the batter after it's mixed perfectly because you can risk overmixing. And as always, you wanna be sure to use a gel food coloring. Very, very, very important, because you do not want any water-based products in your macaron batter because water will deflate your meringue. No liquid food coloring, no water-based anything. Gel food coloring, oil-based, is fine. We're gonna be adding a little bit of brown and yellow gel food coloring to our batter. Once we get that perfect color, we're going to transfer our batter to our piping bag. And guys, today I'm using a nonstick silicone mat with pre-traced circles. I find this makes piping a whole lot easier, consistent piping. So now we're gonna pipe the French macaroons. After you pipe your macaroon shells, we're going to give them a good tap against the counter. That's gonna bring the air bubbles to the surface, and we're going to pop the bubbles with a toothpick. Allow your French macaroons to rest for an hour or until a mat-like crust forms. Then you're gonna bake your macaroons at 300 degrees Fahrenheit with two sheet pans for 15 minutes. While your macaroons are baking, we're going to make my favorite candied bacon. It's the best. Anybody who doesn't like candied bacon, I don't want to know you. Unless you're a vegetarian, that's cool. You know, no beef. So in order to make your candied bacon, we're going to take bacon and sprinkle a little bit of brown sugar over it, and just a touch of paprika. Guys, this is optional. I like a little bit of a spice to it. Bake those at 375 degrees. Keep your eye on it for about 10 to 15 minutes until golden brown. Then you're gonna remove them and quickly remove these and put them on a paper towel to drain because we don't really want any grease in our macarons. I mean, maybe some of y'all might, and that's personal preference. And then once these cooled, we're gonna put them in a food processor and blend, blend, blend. Then we're gonna puree them until they are little crumbles. Now that our macaroons are out of the oven and they look wonderful, we're going to allow them to cool before we top them with our candied bacon. And while they're cooling, we're going to make our maple bacon buttercream. Maple bacon buttercream. Say that fast. Maple bacon buttercream. Maple bacon buttercream. Maple bacon buttercream. Ay, ay, ay. You're gonna take your butter and some maple syrup and confectioner's sugar and mix it in the bowl of a stand mixer. Then we're gonna add our candied bacon, the main character, the guest of honor, to our buttercream. And I'm telling you guys, this buttercream is sick. And I mean sick in a good way, like awesome, like fire, like divine. If you want a guy to marry you, make these maple bacon macaroons. Not even kidding. Now that our macaroons are cool, we're going to use my little secret weapon here. I'd like to make a toast, and it's called Edible Adhesive Dab and Hold by Wilton. You take this in a paintbrush and you're gonna brush it onto the top of your shelves. It's gonna be a little bit shiny, but that's okay, we like that. And then you're gonna sprinkle your candied bacon bits over the shelves until it dries. Then you're gonna fill your shelves with your maple bacon buttercream, baby. Mm-hmm. Oh yeah. Here is the finished product. And do you see how the dab and hold edible adhesive keeps those bacon bits on top without ruining your shells or cracking them? Magic. You guys, these macaroons are fire. I've been making them since I started making macaroons. This recipe is so special that I had to share it with you guys. Guys, thank you so much for tuning into this video. As always, please subscribe to my channel and ring that bell for notifications for even more content. And for even more content that I don't even show on here, please be sure to follow my Facebook and my Instagram page. For all of you guys that are gonna replicate this recipe, please add hashtag creme macaroons to all of your photos and videos so I can like, see, and share them to my stories. Guys, as always, stay safe, stay happy, and keep baking. Sorry, I had to.